Hello friends, welcome back. I am Rinkesh sir, and today we will start with NCERT textual examples of chapter number 7, that is alternating current. Let's start with example number 7.1. A light bulb is rated 100 watt. That means, let's write down the given thing first. Power is equal to 100 watt for a 220 volt supply. The voltage is 220. Find A, the resistance of the bulb, R equal to question mark, the peak voltage, that means Vm equal to question mark, and the V and the RMS current through the bulb, V RMS. Okay, we have to find out these three things. Okay, sorry, it's RMS current. Voltage is already given. It's IRMS. Okay, so now first let's find out the resistance. The formula for resistance, R is equal to V square by P. So it's 220 square upon 100. Let's calculate 220 into 220 divided by 100. It's 484. The resistance is 484 ohm. Okay, so we found out the resistance. The second is Vm, that is maximum voltage. Now we know the formula that V is equal to Vm by root 2, or Vm is equal to root 2 V. So root 2 into V. What is the voltage? That is 220. Let's calculate 2. It's 1.41 square root into 220. So this will be 311. 311 volt. This is the maximum voltage. And third is the RMS current. Now we know V equal to IR. So IRMS. That is equal to VRMS, that is V by R. So here that will be equal to 220 by resistance, that is 484. So it's 220 divided by 484. That is equal to 0.4544 ampere. Clear? So this was about example 7.1. So just note it down. Now let's move to the next one. Example 7.2. Pure inductor of 25 millihenry. Okay, that means inductance is equal to 25 into 10 raised to minus 3 henry. Is connected to a source of 220 volt. VRMS, that will be equal to 220 volt. Find the inductive reactance, means XL equal to question mark, and the RMS current, that is IRMS equal to question mark, if the frequency of the source, that is F, equal to 50 hertz. Okay, so first let's see the XL, that is inductive reactance. Okay, the formula for inductive reactance is omega L. Omega means 2 pi F, where F is the frequency L. So now let's put down the value 2 into 3.14, frequency is 50, and inductance is 20 into 10 raised to minus 3. So now let's calculate it. It's 2 into 3.14 into 50 into 20. That's equal to 6280 into 10 raised to minus 3. Means 6.28 ohm. That is the inductive reactance. Okay, sorry, here inductance is 25, not 20. Let's change it again. So we need to change this answer. Okay, this will be equal to 2 into 3.14 into 50 into 25. So this will be 7850. 7850 into 10 raised to minus 3. That means 7.850. Okay. The next question is IRMS. So IRMS, that will be equal to, if it is resistance, it will be V by R. Here it is inductive reactance, it will be V upon XL. So V is 220 upon XL, that is 7.85. So let's calculate it. It is 220 divided by 7.85. So this is equal to 28.02. So round figure, 28 ampere. This is the current flowing in the circuit. Okay. So this was about example 7.2. So just note it down. Let's move. Example 7.4. A 15 microfarad capacitor is connected to 220 volt 50 hertz source. Find the capacitive reactance. Now see, this is similar to example 7.2. The capacitance is 15 microfarad. Okay, see the capacitance here given is C equal to 15 into 10 raised to minus 6. Sorry, let's change this. It's C. Okay, now it's 220 volt, so V is equal to 220 volt, frequency is equal to 50 hertz. Now you have to find out the if the frequency is doubled, what happens to capacitive reactance? And this is the second part. First, find out the capacitive reactance. So that is XC, that is equal to 1 by omega C. So 1 upon 2 pi FC. So this will be equal to 1 upon 2 into 3.14 into 50 into capacitance 50 into 10 raised to minus 6. So let's calculate it. 1 divided by 2 divided by 3.14 divided by 50 divided by 15. It's an error. So first let's multiply 2 into 3.14 into 15 into 50. So this is 1 divided by 4710. Into 10 raised to minus 6. So this will be equal to 1 upon 4710 into 10 raised to 6. So this will be equal to 1 divided by 4710. So this will be equal to 2.12314 into 10 raised to minus 4. It's minus 4. So 2.12 into 10 raised to minus 4 into 10 raised to 6. So this will be 2.12 into 10 raised to 2. So that will be equal to approximately 212 ohm. Now the current IRMS or current will be equal to V by XC. So that is equal to 220 upon 212. So 220 divided by 212, that is equal to 1.037. So 1.04 ampere. Okay, so the current flowing is 1.04. Now RMS. Okay, V RMS we have found out. Now we have to find out V peak. So this was RMS. So IM, that is maximum current, that is equal to root 2 I. So root 2 into 1.04, so that will be equal to root 2 into 1.04, that will be equal to 1.47 ampere. So the current oscillates between 1.47 plus and 1.47 minus. This is the maximum current or peak current. Now the next question, if frequency is doubled, what happens to capacitive reactance? So if F is doubled, means denominator will be doubled, so XC will be halved. Okay, it will become half, and current that will be doubled. Okay, so that was about question number 7.4. So just note it down. Okay, students, so that's it for today. Thank you.